This is a very quick video showing you a convenient setup for recrystallization. I'm not going to go into the theory of recrystallization, as that will be done elsewhere, just the basic setup for it. Now, to set up the recrystallization in this way, I have a variety of different pieces of glass. We have a recrystallization dish. I have a beaker that has my solid in it, or will have my solid in it, and then the thermometer to measure the temperature. The reason we're using the water bath and the recrystallization dish is because it allows us to conveniently maintain the temperature. If you put the sample directly on the hot plate without the water being present, then your temperature can spike easily or drop easily because you don't have that heat capacity of water to maintain your temperature. So to start with, we want to turn on the hot plate, and we just turn it on. And we're going to adjust the temperature to however we need it. Obviously, 100 is the highest we can go with water. And let's pretend that we're sitting at that temperature then. So let's say we want to use water as our solvent. So I've heated it up to probably about 95 degrees so that it is below the boiling point of water, but it is maintaining the high temperature available with water. And since our outer water bath is water as well, which is what we're using for our solvent, all you need to do is drop water from the outer water bath and add it to your crystals until they all dissolve. Now, you want to have as little water as possible and still maintain the fact that they're all dissolving. You don't want to heat it any more than this because you don't want to evaporate it, and that's the nice thing about the water bath and the fact that you can control that temperature. But let's say, for example, that adding the water just doesn't all dissolve and you need to add a lot of it. Well, eventually you're going to run out of room in this beaker. So what you can do is take the beaker out of the water by raising it up, letting it cool for a minute so that you don't burn yourself, then transfer that material into a larger beaker. Now at this point, because of the fact that you have a large amount of water in here, normally it'll be 20, 30, 40 milliliters of water, that acts as your control in and of itself, and you can put it directly on there. And then you can go ahead and add water to it at the same time as you're heating it. Now to do this properly, the best way to do it actually is to have a second beaker filled with water on the same hot plate so you can maintain the temperature of both of them, transfer from one into the other until it all dissolves. So that's a very convenient way to set up a recrystallization to control the temperature and at the same time use water as a solvent. Now, what about if we don't have water as a solvent and we have a different liquid as our solvent that we want to recrystallize from? Well, in this case, you can set it up the same basic way. Again, having your material in the beaker, and then having that beaker inside the water bath, just like before. So there we have our beaker in, and we also have the thermometer so that we can measure the temperature and so forth. But this time, to actually maintain the temperature on the solvent we're transferring in, all you need to do is add a second beaker with the solvent you're going to be using to the same water bath. Now, by maintaining the temperature in the water bath using the thermometer, instead of taking water from the outside and moving it into your crystals to dissolve it, you would just pull it from your solvent beaker and transfer it over such as this. So very quickly, with the recrystallization dish, thermometer, and a couple beakers, you can set up your recrystallization where you actually control your temperature instead of worrying about your temperature shooting all over the place by putting it directly on.